What is schedule refresh in Power BI? Hi, I am M. Asif Hussain from KnowHow Academy. In this video, we are going to see what is meant by schedule refresh, how to create schedule refresh in Power BI. So let's start working on it. So there is something called as schedule refresh in Power BI. Okay. So when I'm talking about the word refresh, what does it mean? Okay, the general meaning of schedule refresh is that you are going to refresh the data. Okay, you are going to reload. I can even call it as a reload. Okay, reloading the data. Okay, refreshing the data, reloading the data, or reloading the report, or refreshing the report. So what will happen when you are in the process of creating the transformation, when you are in the process of doing the DAX functions, when you are in the process of creating the reports, there are many such possibilities in real-time cases that you have to get the data upgraded. Okay, so the data will be updated. How will the data get updated? There are two things. One, the client. Okay, so one thing what will happen is that when you are working, the client, he or she might come up with the fresh data in middle of your work. Okay, or if you are connecting the data in a direct query mode, or if you are connecting the data in a live connection mode, in the back end part the data will get changed. In the back end part the data might be updated, the data might get some changes in it. Okay, some new columns might be added, some columns might be deleted, some rows might be added, some rows might be deleted, some tables might be added, some tables might be deleted. So there will be many things that might happen in the back end part. When these kind of changes are happening in this back end part, then what will happen? You cannot show the old report, you cannot show the old data to the client, right? You cannot show the old data. With the old data, you cannot prepare the report. Obviously, there are the changes that are happening in the back end part. So now, when these kind of changes are happening in the back end part, how are you going to refresh the data? Okay, every time, no one will come and call you, no one will message you, no one will email you personally all the time that the data is getting updated. Okay, there are some changes happening in the data. There are very less possibilities that someone might inform you regarding the updation of the data. Okay, so now it is also not possible. Okay, for example, if this is Power BI, it is also not possible that you click on this regular refresh option and you get the latest data. Okay, so it is very difficult. Every time you refresh this particular thing that you have with a refresh option in Power BI desktop, you get the latest data of all the reports. Can we expect that you might get the latest data of the reports that you might have prepared? Okay, for example, you have created any DAX function and you want to just refresh it in order to get those DAX function in a visual, or a new formula that you have implemented in a DAX function, or a new visual you have chosen in order to get it. You might do this, all these things, in the refresh option that we have it here in Power BI desktop. But there is something called as schedule refresh. This schedule refresh to be created, this schedule refresh to be enabled after you create the gateway connection. Okay, after you create the gateway connection, first we have to create the gateway connection. And this gateway connection, as we have discussed in our previous videos, there are two modes. Either we have a standard mode or we have it in a direct personal mode. We have two modes. Okay, any mode we can take it. Personal mode is completely depends upon the organization. Personal mode, it purely depends upon an individual for your own cause. Personal mode, that is one. And the standard mode is something where you created as part of an organization's perspective. Okay, so once when you create this gateway, obviously you are linking the data with the gateway. Am I right? So whenever you are creating the gateway, you are linking your data with the gateway that you have created. So in the last video, I have shown you how to create this gateway connection using Power BI in Power BI service. I have shown it to you. So in this Power BI service, if you see here, so in the settings option, in the data model that we have, schematic model, in the settings option, we have these gateway connections that we have created in our previous video. Okay, we have connected this particular data sets that we have in our model. Okay, so we have two data sets, and these two data sets, what I have done, I have logged this one, I have linked up with the data one and data two with the gateway connection that I have created, and it is running. Okay, as you can see the status, this particular data gateway, it is running. Now after you create this data gateway, then you have to create the refresh. Now if you see here, we have an option called refresh. Okay, configure a refresh schedule. In the name itself we have schedule refresh. It's nothing but you are scheduling some time frame. Okay, you are scheduling some time frame. How you are scheduling the time frame? For example, your client, or let me give you a small example, you might see that the WhatsApp might get the backup messages, you know, it will get automatically get backed up. According to me, in my mobile phone, it backs up at 2 a.m. in the morning. Okay, so when the it is getting out, because 2 a.m. is a time frame, 2 a.m. for my WhatsApp messages is a time frame. It might be for everyone also, that I'm not aware of it, but according to me, in my mobile phone, every day at 2 a.m. my WhatsApp messages will get backed up. Okay, so now the point is that in the same way, if you create a time frame for the data, then that on that particular time, that particular data will get updated in the backend part. Okay, so how should we create that? After we create the gateway, we have to on the schedule refresh option. After we on the schedule refresh option, there is a frequency. When do you want to get this data to be refreshed? Do you want it daily? Do you want it weekly? And if you again click on weekly, on which day, on which time zone, you can even select the time zone, on which time zone, we have all the countries' time zones here. Okay, on which day, whether you want only on Monday to Friday, or you want only on Saturday Sunday, or you want only on Tuesday Friday, or you want only on Monday and Thursday, that you can check it out and you can select it here. Once when you select this option, you have time. So by default, Power BI is giving 1 a.m. in the morning. Okay, 1 a.m. in the morning. If you don't want weekly, if you want daily, okay, daily 1 a.m. in the morning, you want the data to get refreshed automatically. This is automatically. Okay, so now what will happen if you don't want only at 1 a.m. you might have a doubt that okay, so though at 1 a.m. the data might get refreshed, but my client, or they might get again, they have the option of getting the data new things and updated in the new things in the data, then you can even add another time. Okay, for example, 1 a.m. in the morning and again 10 a.m. in the morning. So two times I want my data to get refreshed. Okay, 10 a.m. or 10:30, 1 a.m. or 1:30, only two options. Okay, so either a.m. or p.m. Okay, so in these two time frames your data should get refreshed. If you don't want 10 a.m. you choose 10 p.m. in the evening. Okay, so what you have to do, you need to select the frequency of the schedule at what time your data should get refreshed. That you have to select it. If I have chosen it daily for two time frames, if you want weekly, select weekly and click on two time frames. Okay, if you want three time frames like this, you can add the time frames. For example, how many time frames we can add? Let me show you. 1, 2, 3, 4, another time zone, add another time zone, add another time zone. That's it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Why am I getting only 8 times? Why am I eligible only to refresh the data only 8 times? The reason is that for a pro user, the refresh, you can create the data refresh only 8 times. Only 8 times. If you take the premium user, you can take it 48 times. Okay, so as I am a pro user here, as you can see that I am a pro user, and I have taken the free trial version for 60 days, out of which only 46 days are remaining. So I am a pro user, I have the eligibility to refresh the data only 8 times. Okay, so I have 8 times time frame here. So once the whole 8 times that you would like to opt, you can opt it. If you don't want, okay, only 2 times, only 1 time, you can opt it. Okay, and if this particular refresh got failed, Okay, so to whom should we send a notification? You will get an email if it is failed. So for this owner, as I am the owner, I'll get the email. Or if you don't want only to the owner, you want to some other person to be added in this one, then you can select on these contacts and you can enter the email IDs of those people. If you don't want just the owner, click on apply. So every day at 1 a.m. it will get the refresh option, will get notified to you. Okay, if it is getting failed. Okay, if it is not getting failed, the data refresh will happen automatically in the time frame that you have given. So I'll click on apply. So Power BI report schedule refresh got updated successfully. So this is how a data refresh, you know, a schedule refresh to be created in Power BI service. When you are a pro user, I can create only the data refresh for 8 times. If I'm a premium user, I can go with the 48 times. Okay, so this is how you have to create a schedule refresh in Power BI. So thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out to us. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.